Somehow, Combi was back in New Orleans, close to the dock.
Looks like the fog cleared up.
You want to tell me what this is all about?
Welcome, detective, to the greatest show this side of the Mississippi. Nyarlathotep, the Black Pharaoh, the ancient magician who lived a thousand lives and wore a thousand masks.
I can see why you settled on calling him the Dark Man. Saves your breath. So you got scared by a stage magician, and now he's living inside your head.
You can mock me, Detective. You would be the crazy one to think his presence can be ignored. Look where we are!
We didn't get to finish our last conversation, did we? You were about to tell me how to break the contract with the Dark Man.
No, we can't. We would turn him loose on the world. So many innocent would die.
But there is a way to break out of the deal.
There is. You offered me a way out. Steps to take.
What are they?
You'll never find them. They're forever entombed in his sunken desert temple.
Jeremy, I'm not your enemy. Tell me where to go. How do I find the temple?
No, we can't! I have to make this sacrifice!
God damn it, Jeremy! I'm gonna save you! Don't worry!
The Temple of Nefrenkar lies under our camp. Despite all efforts, that unholy site did not collapse, but sink beneath the sand. The Pharaoh is long dead, his name meticulously stricken from all ancient writing. But that stage meant for blood and terror remains. The temple is said to be lightless, built to harbor all the haunters of the dark found in the very depths of our universe. Calling on the gods meant creating a bridge between our world and theirs. The terrible Aldebaran of Taurus, the Black Sun, was seen as the most important star in the night sky. Because according to the Kitab,
sunken desert temple. I better get down there. Here we go. Huh.
Thank you.
Collapse.
Acknowledge psychological trauma, breakthrough barriers of self-deceit, temper-manic behavior. These are the Dark Man's terms. The contract. Huh?
Detective? What are you doing?
I found some.
Great. Was it alcohol?
God, no. I just got the wind knocked out of me. I think I know how to break the contract with the Dark Man.
What exactly does that mean?
Everything going back to normal.
All right. I found some more information on Dorsetto and the patients. There are some seriously strange things going on here. I'm pretty sure two of the patients are dead, and maybe even the clerk.
Oh, yeah. I kind of just gave up on worrying about that.
Well, just keep your eyes open, I suppose. What were you doing again?
Jeremy made a pact with the Dark Man to keep all the madness locked inside Dorsetto.
All right.
I'm gonna break it. I just have to... Where is it? Where's the talisman?
It's around your neck.
Ah! Ah!
I worry, Detective.
Don't. I'm fine.
I worry that you're not much help on this case. But at least you're a good distraction.
Trust me. You're getting your money's worth. At this rate, I'm an absolute bargain.
To be around here somewhere. He wouldn't leave this house.
I don't know what to think anymore. You run into that Dick Bella?
Who is he? Can he be trusted?
I think he wanted a good guy. Well, you know, like us.
Will he be all right with her coming? Praise the mother.
He don't need to know about all that. Just calm down. It ain't time yet.
God. Hurts.
As far as I can tell, Detective Combi seems to be solving problems, not causing them.
Just be ready in case he starts anything.
The two orderlies still hadn't found Jeremy. Combi figured this was good news. Emily had reminded him about some strange...
That.
We
We must have faith that Jeremy's pact with the Dark Man is a bluff. If we are lucky, our visitors will find him and prove it's all nonsense before night falls. What is true is our attempt to call on her. Too many things have happened for this evening to be in vain. Think of Jack and Cassandra, even Perosi, whose circumstances I can't understand.
It's blocked.
Lunacy in the Astarte Artist Colony, a monograph by Yael Klein. In early 1909, the old Derceto plantation outside of New Orleans was turned into an artist's colony. Three famous European artists rented the house and the surrounding land from the owner, the Ledoux family. The colony was chiefly run by Sebastian Cortez, who was playfully dubbed the captain by his collaborators, William Argus and Heinrich Kassel. The colony existed for 6 years, until one day all 12 members disappeared without a trace. It is widely believed that their disappearance is connected to the disastrous hurricane that passed through on September 29, 1915, but nothing truly supports this claim. What is known is their frequent participation in New Orleans nightlife, their love for hosting parties, and their elaborate contributions to the Mardi Gras parades as the Pirates of Punch.
What is that?
Listen, Mrs. Thompson, I understand the last week has been busy. Under these circumstances, I find it important to remind you that Dorsetto's concerns are not a public matter, nor is it something that should upset you. Please continue your excellent work, and don't spend a thought on the death of...
There must be a spare key to Dr. Gray's office in here somewhere. I need the key. I don't have the combination for this, but maybe Jeremy did.
Detective Conby, good to see you again. Solved your case yet?
I'm trying. Hey, Grace, you okay?
Oh, she is just peachy, Detective. Are you looking forward to the Feast of St. John, Grace?
I can't wait.
Kids, ain't they great?
What exactly are you planning for tonight?
Oh, not much. We eat, we drink. Pay tribute to the wishing tree in the conservatory. The usual.
Then why all the excitement?
There is just something about tonight. Something's different. I think we all feel it. Besides, we got ourselves some new words for the prayer thanks to your buddy Jeremy.
She'll come and turn the world inside out, and things will begin again.
That sounds strangely threatening.
You should come.
Oh, God damn it, Grace. Stay put for once.
Better hold on to these. Wouldn't want them to get lost.